So at the outset, I'd like to thank Dr. Kavita and Dr. Amit for giving me this opportunity to speak to you here on SICS and pseudo exfoliation small pupil. Now, small pupil will invariably associated with a little bit of hardness of the cataract. So a little bit of repetition will be there, but it will benefit all of us if we go through it again. So I have no financial disclosures. I have no financial disclosures or commercial interest to disclose. Small pupil is anything less than 4 millimeters, and the general incidence in the population is 2%. And glaucoma, since I practice glaucoma, you have more patients with small pupil presenting, almost up to 60%. And the causes include patients being very old, pseudo exfoliation, meiotic treatment like pilocarpine, diabetic patients. Diabetes, you have to be very careful. You have to think that they are already in a state of pre-rubiosis. And the pupil will become small eventually as you, the hypotony is there during the surgery and also with manipulation. So that's something which you have to keep in mind. Post-uveitis, trauma. Difficulties are that you have difficulty in cataract assessment. You don't know how dense the cataract is, number one. What is the zonular complex stability? Capsulotomy, will it hold or not? You don't know. How big your excess to do is again a doubtful thing. Nucleus delivery, cortex wash, all these become very difficult, and IOL fixation is again a problematic situation. So staining is very important. If you plan to do a small, it's very important you use trypan blue, and then you use the end of the procedure, you use a plug of viscoelastic to plug the side port. And then small people, you'll invariably in uveitic eyes, you'll have a membrane like this. So you have to tackle the membrane before you plan for the procedure. Rexus is important. Like I said, hypotony can cause small pupil. Avoid hypotony while doing rexus. And always use repeat injections of viscoelastic. It doesn't matter if you have to come out with the eye and go back into the eye n number of times. But make sure you do it always in a stable anterior chamber, deep anterior chamber. And you could always try doing a capsulotomy through the side port. And the other idea is you can use 2 strokes out and 1 stroke in, so that you know you may get a cloverleaf capsulotomy rexus, but invariably it will be intact. So in a small pupil eye, you could do something like that. In a small pupil, again, the nucleus prolapse, coming to the nucleus prolapse, is literally a blind procedure. So first is you practice rotating the IOL in the bag. Nucleus in the bag. So once you rotate it nicely, it gets loosened up with the epinucleus, and then it's very easy to manipulate. This is of course a very wide pupil, just showing what you have to do, even if you don't see the nucleus as big as this. Bimanual technique, as Dr. Vijay has already shown, is very rewarding. Difficult situations come if you have an incomplete hydro procedure. So if you have incomplete and it's the nucleus is not rotating, there's something amiss. So be very careful that you know, it should rotate very nicely. Especially this, you'll have a problem if you have a vitrectomized eye and then a breach is there and a posterior capsule, the nucleus may not rotate so well. And small rexus will again cause the problem of prolapsing the nucleus. So the bimanual technique is very useful. You could use a Sinsky. I prefer to use a visco cannula itself because it's very smooth and it's a little broader instrument. And a very soft nucleus, you'll have a prolapsing because you have cheese wiring of the nucleus. Hard drawn wooden nucleus, what will happen is you have the periphery will be very sharp. So it's very important that you inflate the bag with a lot of viscoelastic. So the periphery, the calcified area, doesn't nick the peripheral capsule. So this is another technique. This is something that I want to show you. This is done by Dr. Ramakrishnan of Tirunelveli Aravind Eye Hospital. He uses the bimanual technique in this way. He uses a spatula and through the side port and then just lifts one pole out of the bag and then rotates the whole nucleus into the anterior chamber and very easily does it. This is a little small pupil, you find that you have to rotate the nucleus comfortably. It's not happening, so there's a little bit of struggle. And then again, viscoelastic is injected. Again, hydro is done. And then a bimanual procedure is attempted. So because of cheese wiring, this is not happening. So you find that cheese wiring can happen, especially if you misjudge your nuclear density. So cortex wash and IL fixation are again tricky. You should use a good quality Simcoe cannon. Make sure that it's not rusted or split into multiple layers, because once you enter and come out, you may always nick the posterior capsule. The view is not very good. And preferably to perform in a closed chamber through the side port. You should try to open the fornix of the bag. So chamber should be deep, and the fornix of the bag should get filled in. And then you should keep track of each quadrant which you're cleaning. And try to grasp the anterior leaf of the cortex and remove it. And the IVL is placed in a regular manner. The leading haptic goes into the bag, and then the trailing haptic optic junction is actually dialed in the bag, which again the haptic will follow. The haptic will follow the haptic optic junction and go into the bag. And once you see that it's in the bag, you, especially two-point fixation, you'll find a nice band on the posterior capsule to show that you are in the bag. So then you don't have to fiddle anymore. Sphincterotomies, Dr. Vijay has already showed you. I'll just show you one more sphincterotomy. So if you have a uveitic patient, you have to take care of the membrane. So this is the peeling of the membrane. And then after that, you can give small sphincterotomies. So membrane is very tough and rigid. You have to pull it all around, and then the membrane comes off. And then small sphincterotomies are given a few millimeters away. And if you cut too much into the iris, you may induce monocular diplopia. You can cause bleeding. And small cuts are usually sufficient. And these will usually marginally dilate the pupil. They won't dilate the pupil fully. So once you inject viscoelastic, you find that it is wider than before. Pupil is dilated well. Stretch pupilloplasties, again, you use Kuglin's hooks. So these are ways in which you can manage rigid meiotic pupil, you can manage with a, or pseudo-exfoliation pupil, we can manage with a Kuglin's hooks. They are used in pairs from the opposite direction, and anterior chamber should be well formed, and care should be taken to avoid damage to the anterior capsule. Unfortunately, all pupils don't dilate with stretch, and sometimes they do make the iris very floppy, and too many tears can occur, so you have a ragged iris tags. And pupil can subsequently become smaller during surgery. You may end up with a mid-dilated clover leaf or an irregular pupil post-operatively. Iris retractors are more sophisticated, and because of less sphincter tear, they're easy to apply, can be used at any stage of the surgery, and they're not very expensive. So there are various models. Now you have the Mal-Eugen ring, also the BHEX by Dr. Suvin Bhattacharya. So it's very easy to use them. You have four, and then you can do the capsulotomy and other procedures. Iris hooks, you have to remember that stab wound should be at the limbus, avoid injury to the anterior capsule. Cortex can get caught near the hooks, so be very careful. Iris plane is brought more anteriorly, so actually the antechamber is almost ceases to exist. So when you bring out the nucleus, you have to make sure that you release the iris hooks and then bring out the nucleus into the anterior chamber. Ideally, four hooks should be used 90 degrees apart. So this is just to show you Mal-Eugen ring. Pseudo-exfoliation cataract is very important. You have to make sure you rule out glaucoma along with pseudo-exfoliation. And this is one of the cases where Dr. Vijay has mentioned, sometimes you may have very poor endothelial. So this is a patient with very poor endothelium in which cataract is being performed. So you have to use good quality, high viscoelastic devices, and repeatedly fill the chamber with that. And always make sure that you may have to use a CTR in these situations too, before even you prolapse the nucleus into the anterior chamber. So the bag is extremely very weak, and then very difficult to prolapse the nucleus into the dense brown cataract. And then wash is again has to be done meticulously, but at the same time very carefully. and placing the IOL. Prefer to place the IOL in the sulcus and then capture it in the bag if possible. But view will be so difficult that you know getting it into the eye and making it stable is more than sufficient in many of the cases. So donor dialysis, the approach, the bimanual prolapse of the nucleus, phaco sandwich, all these are helpful in patients with donor dialysis. So avoid hypotony. The main take-home point is avoid hypotony. Stain the capsule, capsule excess, hydro procedure, have to be very careful. Cortex wash done through the side port and IOL fixation in a fully formed antechamber. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ganesh.